The West Indies cricket team is still celebrating its drought-breaking 8-run win over Australia at the Gabba. 24-year-old Shamar Joseph was the star of the match. He took 7 wickets to push his team to its first test victory on Aussie soil in 27 years, leaving the home side stunned. And the superstar himself, Shamar Joseph, is here. Shamar, what an outstanding performance. Congratulations. How big has the party been? Because you look pretty well put together at the moment.
Yeah, it's just been a lot. I do not party that much. I do not drink or so I just went to bed, spent a little time with the guys down here, you know, sit, have a conversation, talk, laugh, and then I went to my room and just get some rest.
It's incredible what you did. And more incredible, the night before, you had that injured toe. I think you're off to hospital. You're having scans. As I was watching you take wicket after wicket, I'm just thinking, he can't keep going. You were bent over in pain. You could hobbling in the outfield. I just thought, this, eventually he's got to stop. How much pain were you in as you were destroying us?
Yeah, there was a lot of pain, to be fair, but I wasn't studying about it that much. All I was studying was just about winning. Know how important the win is to us. I just had to go through that phase. That pain actually encouraged me to keep going and moving forward.
You also weren't expected to play, so you didn't have your gear. You were just going to watch. Was there a point that you honestly thought you might have to play in your boxers?
Well, I was just in the dressing room. I was just waiting on my clothes to come because most of the guys thought that I wouldn't make it to play.
Do you think running into bowl in your boxers could be a new tactic in world cricket to put the batsman off?
That would be a shame, but that would be so much shame. Yeah, but I think that would be a good solution at the end of the day.
Before you started knocking over Australian batsmen, you were knocking over people as a security guard. How did you rate the security at the Gabba last night?
Well, if I were them, I was asleep because I used to be sleeping a lot in the work. So, you know, it's not easy being a security guard, you know. Elevating from security guard to a cricketer, couldn't ask for better, to be fair. And seeing those guys there last night, standing around the field, looking at us, looking over us, protecting us, you know, I must give a shout out to them. If they're hearing me, I must give a shout out to them. I was once in that position, staying up all night, looking after buildings, other peoples, and you know these things. So they did a great job throughout these 2 test matches. And, you know, we really appreciate everything that they do for us there.
This is a man who knows his security.
Absolutely.
I've never heard anyone give as thorough a review of the security at a test match. Hey, I just should point out, Shamar, we don't do this. When someone comes along and destroys Australia in a sporting competition, we don't speak to them the next day. We try to forget it ever happened and never talk about it ever again. And yesterday there was something so magic about it. Every Australian I know was actually cheering for you. Absolutely. And for the West Indies. There was something magic in the air. Did you get that sense? Maybe not during the game, but afterwards?
The fans from Australia here, I think it's amazing that they support both sides. It doesn't matter where you came from. But I think the love for cricket that they have is amazing. So I think the support that they bring out here, and I think they come out to see us give Australia a challenge, knowing that there's a young group of men come 7 debutants in experience, come to play test cricket and just show up and, you know, do well. So I think what we did there, that is what changed the whole, you know, the mindset of the fans, and, you know, they keep cheering for us and keep supporting us. So that actually gave us an extra boost into the second test match, and we enjoy it. We enjoy every moment of the fans there.
Mate, it was amazing to watch. I felt like I was in the 80s or the 90s for a moment there, watching you tear in like that. Congratulations, and here's to hoping that we see a lot more of you playing test cricket, yeah?
Yeah, sure, sure will. Sure, by God's grace, sure will. Well, God give me health and strength, I will continue playing test cricket.
Thanks, mate. Congratulations.
Oh. Thank you, sir.